Here we go. Four games to go. Football Manager Season 2, Inter Miami versus Columbus Crew. Fixture 31. If we win, we win the Supporters' Shield. We get our first managerial trophy on YouTube. And yeah, it's a big game. We're at home to Columbus Crew, and they beat us last time. Sorry, it was 2-2, sorry about that. But we had to pull the game back, and it was that game where they really got at us right away, and we were lucky to get some from the game, really. And we switched to defensive early on, and it was too late because they already got the two goals. So this game here, if we win the game, we'll go 11 points clear with 3 games to go. And that obviously means there's only 9 points to play for there for second place New York City FC. If we draw the game, we'll go 9 points clear. That doesn't really mean that a tight, if we draw the game with more or less, we're grabbing the trophy, but we haven't officially won it, because we could lose all 3 games after that and they could win. It's unlikely. If we lose the game, obviously the title race is still on, but if we win today, we're champions of the MLS Supporters Shield, and then we'll go right into the semi-finals of the MLS playoffs. So it's a big game today. Here we go. Columbus Crew, scouting reports came in, they play with a cautious mentality, and team fluidity is fluid. The strengths are a high level of teamwork is often on display. Robinson's work ethic may help to combat this. The team in general are impressive markers who work hard to deny their opponent time and space, and that's what they've done in the last game. Weaknesses: vision is not one of the team's better collective attributes, and stamina isn't a collective plus point. But they did really come at us right away in the last game. We panicked a bit. But yeah, we're 10-11 favourites on to win the game. And as it says here, Inter Miami could secure qualification to the semi-final of the playoffs by beating Columbus today. We attended the pre-match press conference. One of the questions was, how do you get your team to repeat the sort of performance they put in against Chicago? And I just replied with, we have to keep working hard. If we do that, the possibilities are endless. It should be a close contest between two very evenly matched teams. They are well below us in the league. But obviously, if you watch the game, the last time we played them a few games ago, they really got on us early and we struggled. Some good news is Victor Ochoa, after 4 months out following a broken ankle, is back in full training, and he's actually going to be in the squad today because we're lacking with injuries and suspensions. He can play 45 minutes, as you can see here. So he's going to be on the bench for this game. Gregorio will miss the game through suspension because he picked up too many yellow cards, so he actually misses this game. And the fans are looking forward to this in the social feed as well. Ochoa looked pretty sharp in the training videos. I trust Ochoa to be straight back in the team then. Having recovered from a broken ankle, welcome back Victor Ochoa. But they are excited. Look, if you read these here, I hope Marsman starts here. We need our most confident players involved. This isn't the match to start as well. I mean, it will be. I'll be happy when it's confirmed. I'm stressing out. Can't relax until I hear the final whistle being blown. The stakes are high for Inter Miami, but they are well equipped to step up to the plate. The qualification dream can be made a reality with one good performance today. Yeah, so if we win, we'll win the Supporters' Shield. So we'll win the league title, which is, believe it or not, the secondary title in the MLS. The actual MLS playoffs are the one to win the whole thing, which is quite odd, but it is what it is. But it's a huge achievement anyway if we win the league title. It's in our first year as well at Inter Miami. Analysis of their attacking and defensive performance indicates that although they are defensively shaky, they are good in attack. We'll have to keep an eye out at the back, but shouldn't struggle while attacking. Opposition instructions: we should instruct our players to show Darlington Nagbear onto his weak foot. We should instruct our players to show James Egbekeme onto his weak foot. I think we should tell our players not to hold back when tackling Chucho Hernandez. It would be sensible to go in hard but fair on Lucas Salarian. Them two basically ran the game last time we played them, so we need to really be on them this time. So we're going to do that. So this is how I'm setting up for this game. I was going to play Jovan Jones on the left, but I played Kieran Gibbs, and I'll tell you why in a second. But Harvey Neville's going to play instead of Yedlin, because Yedlin's injured. And George Acosta, despite his contract dispute and was stolen on that, he's going to start the game in place of suspended Gregoria. So our bench is a bit thin, as you can see. But the same, we're going to start with an attacker mentality and the same principles when we're in possession, the same principles when we're in transition. So a counter press and counter attack player, and the same principles when we're out of possession. If they go with us right away, like they did in the last game, that's the reason I'm playing Kieran Gibbs, because we might need to change to defensive quite quick. And I'd rather have Kieran Gibbs playing a defensive role than Jovan Jones, because Jovan Jones gets forward a bit more into these places here. So that's the team I'm going with. Can we win the title, or is the story gonna continue? George Acosta's hurt about playing out of position and his contract. But he's played so well there, hopefully he can do one last job really. The dressing room doesn't agree with today's team sheet. I know, but we haven't been playing that well, so I need to make some type of changes. Time to win. Marquez has got it right by starting Sailor. So Nick Marsman in goal, Harvey Neville, Amy Mavica, Christina McVeigh, Ryan Sailor, Kieran Gibbs, George Acosta, Sean Motta, Ari Lasseter, Emerson Rodriguez, and the captain, Gonzalo Higuain. Columbus Crew, manager Yapstam, Eloy Voon, Stephen Moreira, Jonathan Mensa, Milos Deganek, Pedro Santos. Jonathan Mensah's the captain, by the way. Perry Kitchen, Darlington Nagbear, James Ikegeme, Yoel Yeboah, Chucho Hernandez, and Lucas Salarian. If we win, we can win the title, but let's not get carried away. This match we should be winning, make sure we do. A win could take us into the semi-final. Let's make sure we do all of it. So that's basically that. So I'm going to say what the assistant is saying. It always helps to be as prolific as your team have been recently, right? It's all about consistency. We need to make sure that we're able to find that sort of quality all over the pitch. How has Gregorio's suspension affected your plans? These things happen, so it's up to the squad to make sure we don't miss him too much. Does being the MLS leading goal scorers give you confidence that you are always going to be in with a chance of winning? There has to be a balance, of course, and we work on everything in training. Goals make headlines, but they don't tell the full story. So a win will make us the Supporters' Shield champions. Well done. Well, it's a better start than the last time we played them, put it that way. Thank you. Not all. Ball. Oh. That's one chance. Side, surely. Going okay so far. Well, I mean okay. Not great, just okay. Defence still looks a bit shaky, a bit nervous. Columbus Crew aren't gonna want to spoil the party today, aren't they? We've got two away games after this as well. So if we don't win the game, it's not over by a long shot, really. Just need to keep our composure. Concentrate. Rodriguez. Very tight in defence today. They're just sort of doing what we do, collecting the ball and then passing it out. They know what they're doing. free kick to us. Offside, Hernandez. Just I know Jorge Costa's playing out of position, he's purposely. Tight game. Oh, Costa's injured. Twisted ankle. Oh no, already. Oh. We're going to swap him with Joe Motta. Bring on Pozuelo. I was going to bring Victor Ojoa on to play in that, but he's just come back from injury. So we're going to have to make an early change already. I'm going to say there's no pressure on you tonight. So Jean Motta's going to have to drop back to where Acosta was playing in that defensive midfield role. Ball with the midfielder, and Pozuelo's going to be the attacking midfielder. I think that hit the post or the outside side netting. We're getting closer. Mabeka nearly again. Well done, Higuain, the press. Oh. Query. Kick. Oh no, here we go. too. That's why we're a bit iffy still. Start again. Ball. Push would be. Let's start again. Oops. We've had our chances, we've some put them away. And an injury. We've had 9 shots over there, 4, 3 each on target, 0.74 XG over there, 0.33, 2-1 on corners, 10-6 on fouls, no yellow cards each, 87% passage completion rate, they've had 90, and we've only had 44% of their possession over in their 56. We put out a good performance according to our XG. Our XG was great in our opponents. It seems like Eamon Rabica is not used to the pressing intensity being asked of him today. That's the key factor. We're not getting enough of the ball that we'd like, and we're not putting our chances away. But we'll go again. Keep going, we can win this if we work hard as a team. Maybe switch to defensive, you know. Yeah, switch to defensive, they're getting a bit more of the ball. Thank you.
Thank you.
particular. Thank you.
Yes!
Baker may have scored the goal that has won us the Supporters' Shield and our first ever trophy on YouTube. Set piece, of course, that was going to be the difference. Robinson, at least he's walked off. Looks like our tactics were right. No rush now. Just a minute and a half to go. We could be booking our place in the semi-finals of the playoffs. Joa, first game back in 4 months from injury, crossed it in as well. Trevor Robinson back on, I think he is. It'll have to be anyway, we've got no subs left. Blow the whistle, ref. Robinson! Oh. That's it, blow the whistle, ref.
Yes!
We left that late, but we win the game. Eamon Mabeka, man of the match, 8.1 rating, and the winning goal as well. Look at that, 90 plus 1. Wow, we put out a good performance according to our XG, our XG was greater than our opponents. Look at the stats, we had 20 shots over their 6, 6 on target over their 4, 1.30 XG over their 0.45, 6 corners over their 2, we had 16 fouls over their 10, no yellow cards, believe it or not, in the match, 86% passes completed, they had 88%, that's how close it was. And we only had 42% of the possession, they had 58%. But we left it late, but we got the job done. Nice one all. We've qualified for the semi-final of the playoffs. That was tough. It doesn't look like we're going to be crowned the Supporters Shield champions until the end. But no idea whether you lift a trophy or not. But it would be nice. But if not, cool.
Yeah?
Yeah?
Yeah, no.
What?
Yeah, no.
Yeah, it'll be 5 minutes.
Achievement in the MLS Supporters Shield. Just hope it doesn't lead to complacency next season. Let's kick on from here. What a time to be an Interim supporter. MLS Supporters Shield champions. Shoulder bite, not reach up 5 centimeters per play, and ultimately outmatched on the day, falling to defeat against their baby followers. Into Miami's Acosta was forced off a twisted ankle in the 19th minute following an attempted tackle on Darlington Nagabe. With the game nearing an end, it was Eamon Mbeki who scored a mighty header from within the 6-yard box to give Into Miami the lead on 91 minutes. Mbeki's impact delighted the fans with his late goal today. Into Miami struggled to seize possession, but was still able to manage more efforts of goal. Into Miami are currently on a 4-match unbeaten run in the league, and the title contenders lie first place in the MLS. Into Miami won 4 of their last 5 home league games, that guaranteed the highest league finish, with the previous record being 90, but were the champions. Into Miami won the Supporters Shield. Inter Miami won the MLS Supporters Shield title.
Gonzalo Higuain led the way to glory for the league leaders by notching 17 goals en route to sealing the Supporters Shield crown. Inter Miami currently on a 4-match unbeaten run in the league, and the title contender line them. Inter Miami's impressive end to the season leaves them firmly in the title picture as they sit first in the table with the finish line in sight. Marquez lifted the MLS All-Stars game trophy with MLS All-Stars in July and can now add success with the Inter Miami CF to a growing list of honours in an impressive managerial career. San Jose, Nashville and LAFC have guaranteed themselves playoff places. San Jose are currently on a 5-match unbeaten run and find themselves in first place in the MLS. The impressive end of the season leaves them firmly in the title picture as they sit first in the table with the finish line in sight. Georgia Costa injured, is on 4 weeks to 2 months, despite that report that attacking midfielder Georgia Costa sustained a twisted ankle while making a tackle in Inter Miami's match against Columbus. A twisted ankle can either be treated by the club's physios or managed by injections. Might make it back for like the last game. Might. Need a physio. Looks like it's his season over pretty much. Good behaviour rule for Saylor. After being just one yellow card away from suspension, Ryan Saylor's been rewarded by the FA after he managed to play 5 consecutive matches without being booked. One of his previous yellow cards has been stricken from his record, meaning that he now requires a further 2 bookings before his ban comes into place. The good behaviour incentive rule can only be applied 3 times per season for a single player. However, this is only the first time Saylor used this incentive so far this campaign. It's actually not. It's the second time. Inter Miami qualified for the semi-final. Inter Miami have qualified for the semi-finals of the MLS Eastern Conference. The league leaders will be delighted to have qualified so easily with a remarkable 3 games in hand. Yes, look at that. Marquez brings glory to Inter Miami. Inter Miami fans are in jubilant mood after Massive Marquez led them to an incredible feat of winning the MLS Supporters Shield. Yes! A fan spokesperson announced Marquez was undoubtedly one of the best managers around. Inter Miami board delighted with the Supporters Shield win. Inter Miami board have issued a statement declaring they are very happy with the victory in the Supporters Shield and are grateful to a manager like Massive Marquez for doing the club proud. They put on record their complete surprise at such a remarkable achievement, gave all credit to Marquez for an impressive individual success whilst bringing unbridled joy to the club supporters. There it is, the Supporters Shield. The minimal expectation that this team attempted to become competitive in the Supporters Shield. The board of players of the team won the Supporters Shield this season. There is no doubt that the fine run of results at the end of the season helped us in overachieving. Look at that performance. Inter Miami received 173,000. Awarded the allocation fund of 173,000 for winning the Supporters Shield. This brings Inter Miami CF's total general allocation money up to 375k. As per the league rules, any leftover money from the general allocation money fund just awarded will be halved if not used within 3 seasons and will be forfeited entirely within 5 seasons. Georgia Costa has picked up a nasty injury today and can be placed on either the disabled list or the season ending injury list. I'm not going to put him on any because he might be back for the last game. Mabeka shines as Inter Miami win. Ian Mabeka was the best player on the park during Inter Miami's 1-0 MLS win over Columbus this evening, and the margin of victory should have been even greater. The central defender bagged the only goal of the game late on to round off his performance by scoring a mighty header from the 6-yard box. The defender played well and was relentless in defence, even managing to get up the other end and score a goal. Mbeki has made 31 interceptions and 96 headers for Inter Miami this season. He was drafted to the MLS in 2021, the first round pick in the Super Draft. I'm going to praise his performance, put my arm around him, which appeared to improve his body language. I'm really pleased with how you played in the last match and that you scored. Keep up the good work. Great having this talk with you. Let me know if you need anything else. Attend the press conference. You've shocked a lot of people by winning the MLS with your unfancied Inter Miami team. Was it luck more than anything else that won it for you? It wasn't lucky, it was hard work and the ability that won this competition. Just how proud are you to add the MLS to the Inter Miami Silverware cabinet? Well, it's the only time of winning. I'm absolutely delighted. This is a special day for everyone at the club. After winning the MLS Supporters Shield, surely the board and fans are going to be even more demanding. Won't this put pressure on you as a manager? No. I was going to say, wow, you really want that enjoy today, will you? Today is a great moment for Inter Miami, but looking forward, can you build on this success and challenge for more trophies in the future? I wouldn't want to speculate on that for now, let's just enjoy today. Your unbeaten home run now stands at 10 league matches. How important is it to make sure that the DRB PNK Stadium becomes a fortress for Inter Miami? If you're asking me whether or not winning is important, then I think you already know the answer. How much did you enjoy Eamon Mbeki's performance? It was a good team performance overall, but he did stand out as one of the best players on the pitch, yes. With silverware secured, you must be pleased that the club appears to be on course to realising its long-term vision. We're not getting ahead of ourselves, this is all part of the process. So yeah, we've won. That was just what I went through in press conference. So yeah, we've won the support shield. We've gone on and won it. And there's the official announcements. Inter Miami fans in jubilant mood. So, yeah, that is in the history books, isn't it? We won the supporters' shield. DC United away next. No rest for the wicked. Post-match analysis. We should be happy with the result. We were only a little bit better than our opposition, but the scoreline is what matters the most. We won the match deservedly. We created better opportunities than our opponent. We completed a decent number of passes in the match. They completed a large number of passes in the match. We scored none of our 8 shots attempted from outside the penalty area, conceding none of the 4 shots attempted from inside the penalty area. That's the DC United Skeleton Report, but yeah. Champions of the Supporters Shield. Look at that. Yes. And yeah, we're into the semi-finals of the playoff places, so It's going to be an interesting end to the season, boys. We'll prepare for the DC United game. Let's go.